वीर्यं करवा वही तेजस्वी धीतुस्तुलाविद्युषावहै ॐ शांति शांति शांति। जो ब्रह्मांड विदधाति पूर्वं यो वेदागुच्छ प्रज्ञोत तस्मै तगुं आत्मबुद्धि प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शांति शांति शांति। श्री चिद्घन गणेशाय नमो मह्यम। सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धिर्दृक्यत्व निर्मरं अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेव अहन्नमत वत्तोऽन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। In the sequence of looking at Khyatiwadas, we have landed at the Anirvachaniya Khyati, which is the Siddhanta, and it has been established in one way how the Sarpa Brahma that has come up will go away, and at the same time how the Sarpa Jnana will go away. Sarpa as a Padartha goes away by Rajju Jnana because it has come up by Rajju Ajnana. Rajju Jnana counters the Rajju Ajnana, which is the Ajnana which is present in the Rajju Avachinna Chaitanya. And Rajju Jnana itself is Rajju Avachinna Chaitanya. Thereby, Rajju Avachinna Chaitanya, which is Adhisthana, that becomes known when Rajju Jnana takes place. So, Rajju Jnanena, Rajju Avachinna Chaitanyena, because it is Chidrupa. Jnana is Chidrupa, which is Adhisthana. Adhisthana Jnanena, Sarpa Nivritti. Sarpa as a Padartha. Then, how does the Sarpa Jnana go? Same reason. Sarpa bhavat, sarpa vishaya bhavat, sarpa jnana nivrittihi. Although it is within, the adhikarana may be different, but adhikarana jnana is not needed. Adhikarana in the case of sarpa jnana is sakshi chaitanya. So sakshi chaitanya being the adhisthana, sakshi chaitanya has to be known. Purvapakshi had questioned, how can sarpa jnana go, although sarpa as a padartha, sarpa as a vishaya goes away. We gave multiple level answers. One, we said vishaya bhavat sarpa jnana nivrittihi. But then he says, no, you have to give me adhikarana. Adhikarana jnana, adhisthana jnana. Adhisthana jnana should take place. So we gave an example that adhishtha jnana need not rise for the sarpa jnana nivritti, by giving an example of Nivritti being Laya Rupa, as in Shushupti and Pralaya, where the Adhisthana Jnana is not needed. When the Prarabdha Karma is over, then one goes to sleep, or Pralaya takes place when Samashti Prarabdha is over. Laya Rupa Nivritti. For that, Adhisthana Jnana is not needed. For Atyantiki Nivritti, the Adhisthana Jnana may be needed. Their Atyantiki Nivritti is along with its Karana. Meaning Nivritti, Karya Karana both go away. There the example was the Tantu being burnt completely, Pata also gets burnt. Here we don't have that Apeksha also. Karana Jnana, Adhisthana Jnana, Apeksha itself is not there because it is Laya Rupa. That was one way it was explained, and thereby Sarpa Bhava Sarpajnanasya Karane Laya Rupa Nivrittihi Samadhi. That was the Samadhi given here, Samadhana given to the question. So Sarpajnanam Antara Api Sarpajnanam Nivarteta Iti Samadhanam. Without the Sarpajnana also, Adhishtana Jnana, Sakshi Jnana Mantara. Sakshi Jnana Mantara Api Sarpajnanam Nivarteta Iti Samadhanam. Sakshi Jnana is not needed. For that we saw the example. And then Athava, otherwise, another option given is Rajju Jnana Samaye Sarpa Jnana Adhisthana Bhuta Sakshi Bhanam Api Sambhavati. इति समाधानम्। द पूर्व पक्षी हैज ऑब्जेक्टेड टू द पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ अधिष्ठान ज्ञान एंड इफ यू से अधिष्ठान ज्ञान इज नीडेड वी कैन गिव एन आंसर इन अनदर वे। अधिष्ठान ज्ञान इज चैतन्य ज्ञान, चैतन्य इज वन इन सिद्धांत। वेन इज इट डिफरेंट? वेन इट इज outside and inside delimited by different upadis, then we give it a notional difference. Give them, between them there is notional difference, there is no real difference. Chaitanya cannot be different, cannot be segmented at all, it is all upachariki, upachara, like ghatakasha 1, ghatakasha 2, we have seen multiple times. So we have to keep on bringing back that idea, even if we have to explain by chaitanya jnana, adhishtana jnanena, sarpajnana nivrutti, that can also be done. How so? Rajju jnana samaye, when the rajju jnana takes place, what is happening? There rajju avachinna chaitanya is known, is swayameva prakashate. When the rajju vritti, this is rajju jnana vritti rupa takes away the rajju ajnana, then the rajju avachinna chaitanya is revealed. So what is happening then? Rajju jnana samaye sarpa jnana adhishthana bhuta. What is the adhishthana of sarpa jnana? Sarpa jnana adhishthana is sakshi. So sarpa jnana adhishthana bhuta sakshi bhanam api sambhavati. You think that the sakshi chaitanya is not revealed, but sakshi chaitanya is also revealed. In fact, without sakshi chaitanya, who is going to know the sarpa? Who is going to have rajju jnana? Rajju jnana is sakshi bhasya. Rajju is sakshi bhasya. Rajju jnana is also sakshi bhasya, so is known by the sakshi. Sakshi is ever there, nothing is unknown to the sakshi. So sakshi not being revealed, who will really light up the rajju jnana, meaning rajju vritti also, who will light up? Chaitanya which lights up is sakshi rupa. So rajju jnana samaye sarpa jnana adhishthana bhuta sakshi bhanam api sambhavati, it is possible. How so? Iti samadhanam, that is also another possibility. Athava sarpaha tajnanam cha iti ubhayam api rajju jnaneneva nivartate. Both will go away, sarpa as well as sarpa jnana will go away by rajju jnana. Tathahi, how so? Tathahi rajju sakshatkara samaye, when the Rajju Jnana takes place, which is by here now. Meaning Rajju Sakshatkara. Sakshatkara, when you say it is internal, but then the Rajju is outside. Rajju Sakshatkara Samaye, meaning Pratyaksha, Aparoksha Jnana has taken place, that there is Rajju, there is no Sarpa. So Rajju Sakshatkara Samaye, Antakkaranam Netra Dwara, Chakshu, the Chakshu Gata, from the Chakshu, through the Chakshu. Chakshu is the Indriya. So Chakshu Indriya goes and it falls on, the Indriya falls on the Rajju. Earlier also it had taken place, but Idam Amsha was known. Now what has happened? It has fallen on the Rajju and Antakkarana has been drawn, Vritti Rupa. So Netra Dwara Bahir Nirgatya Antakkarana. Antakkarana goes along with the Indriya, Chakshu Indriya. How? Through the Golaka, Netra Golaka, then Netra Dwara Bahir Nirgatya, Rajju Desham Prapya, Tat Samana Akara Bhavati. This is what we call as Rajju Akara Vritti. When Tat Samana is Rajju Samana, once it takes the Rajju Akara, Ataha, what happens then? Rajju Sakshatkara Samaye Vrityupa Hita Chaitanyam. The Vritti, Antakkarana Vritti has taken place. This is more detail. We have seen all this, but then there is more detail here. To explain how the sarpa jnana nivritti also takes place via the sakshi chaitanya being known. Rajju sakshatkara samaye mrityupahita chaitanyam. The antakkarana which has gone out, that antakkarana modification is called as vritti. And when the antakkarana went out, how can the antakkarana go out? Antakkarana is jada, it cannot go out. Antakkarana by itself cannot move. It cannot even take the form of vritti. Chakshu also cannot, indriya cannot function. Keneshitam preshitam patati manaha, asks the Kenopanishad in the first mantra itself. Who is behind all this? for the entire jada prapancha, including the sharira, indriyas and antakarana, who is behind it? It's a loaded question. Manaha is an indicative there of other things also. Because other things do come up in time in the Upanishad. So there is a Chaitanya Vastu backing. Who is that Chaitanya Vastu? The Chaitanya Vastu is without any segmentation, it is one. However, when the question is phrased Antakkarana, how does the Chakshurindriya go out? Chakshurindriya is not going out due to Rajju Achinna Chaitanya. Rajju is outside, there may be Chaitanya there as well. But why has the Indriya gone outside? Even if we say, oh, there is Kama, there is Raga, Dvesha, whatever you bring in, still how do they function? They function because the Sakshi sitting inside. That Sakshi is giving prerana for the Indriyas, prodding the Indriyas to act, to do whatever they do. They do whatever they do because of the presence of Sakshi. Therefore, the Sakshi is present. Chaitanya Rupa Sakshi is there in the Antakkarana. Then, this Antakkarana, when it goes out following the Indriya, that time the Chaitanya is already there. Chaitanya is everywhere, but we'll specifically say which Chaitanya, although Chaitanya does not travel, Chaitanya cannot travel. Chaitanya is everywhere, it does not travel, cannot travel, need not travel. Chaitanya is everywhere. Now this Chaitanya which has prodded the Indriyas to act, that Chaitanya is within the Antakkarana. Also outside, but within the Antakkarana is the part that we look at, although it cannot have a part. But in technical analysis, we should do Bheda, just like Ghatakasha 1, Ghatakasha 2, we have separate, because the question is about two different Chaitanyas being there. One Chaitanya is revealed, which is Rajjo Achinna Chaitanya. Purupakshi wants to know, how is Sakshi Chaitanya known? Without that Adhishtana being known, you cannot have the Sarpajnana Nivritti, which is Brahma, Adhyasa, Aropita. That Nivritti cannot take place. So we are saying that Sakshi Chaitanya is known. How is it known? We are explaining why the Vritti, as to the Chaitanya which is backing the Antakkarana, which has taken the form of Vritti, which is following the Chakshurindriya outside, has Chaitanya, Sakshi Chaitanya sitting within, as though traveling. Because as long as wherever there is Antakkarana, there the Sakshi has to be there. Antakkarana cannot go out. Antakkarana, Vritti Rupa Antakkarana goes out. But the Jiva, who says that I had Sarpa, I had seen Sarpa outside, now I am seeing Rajju, that person, he is the one who will have knowledge. So he is the real Sakshi. His real Sarupa is Sakshi. So Vritti Upahita Chaitanya, which is the part of the Vritti now. Vritti is backed by Chaitanya, which is as though sentient. So, Ataha Rajju Sakshatkara Samaye Vritti Upahita Chaitanyam Rajju Upahita Chaitanyancha. The Rajju Upahita Chaitanya, which is outside, Iti Ubhayam Api Eki Bhavati. It becomes one, which was as though two, now becomes as though one. Otherwise, you cannot say that I know something else. You cannot know unless you become one with it. So, what is happening is really the Chaitanya backing the Vritti Antakkarana as well as the Chaitanya which is in the Rajju Vishaya. It is forming a Triputi. That Triputi is becoming one. What Triputi is becoming one? The Chaitanya underlying the so-called Triputi Bheda is becoming one. That is why one can say that I know the Rajju. There is a Rajju, and then I know the Rajju. There is Rajju Sakshatkara. So what is happening is the Chaitanya, currently only two, Vishayagata Chaitanya, which is what? Upadhi. Vishaya is an Upadhi. And then Vrittigata Chaitanya, which is Vritti is an Upadhi for the Chaitanya. This second Chaitanya. Not say Vritti Upahita Chaitanya, second in my statement. So here in the sentence printed, the first Chaitanya, Vritti Upahita Chaitanya, is nothing but Sakshi Chaitanya. And Rajju Upahita Chaitanya is outside. This Rajju Upahita Chaitanya is known by Rajju Sakshatkara. To this, there is no objection. Once this Vritti Upahita Chaitanya and Rajju Upahita Chaitanya become one due to Vritti going there, how can you say that the Vritti Upahita Chaitanya is equal to Sakshi Chaitanya is not known? Cannot make such statements. You can't say that I agree with the Rajju Upahita Chaitanya being known and then Vritti Upahita Chaitanya, Sakshi Chaitanya is not known. So this is the real answer. Na tayor asti bhedaha. There is no difference between Rajju Upahita Chaitanya and Vritti Upahita Chaitanya, which is Sakshi Chaitanya. There was never a difference, but since Upadi Krita Bhedas are there, those Upadi Krita Bhedas are also not there. Why? Because they have become one. Ajnana, which had segmented it, at least in that particular desha, it is not that the Chaitanya completely has become one. It is already one, does not need to become one. But other Ajnanas are still there. What Ajnana has gone? The Rajju Upahita Chaitanya, only that part of the Chaitanya, which has an avarana of Rajju Jnana, Rajju Ajnana. Rajju Ajnana has caused avarana in the Rajju Jnana Chaitanya, that part, which is revealed by the Rajju Jnana, taking away Rajju Ajnana. Therefore, Rajju Avachinna Chaitanya becomes known. Now, only with that part, this Sakshi Chaitanya has become one, which is Sakshi Chaitanya again not complete. Even if you have to talk about Sakshi Chaitanya separately, we can talk about part of Sakshi Chaitanya also. As though part, which part, which is the Vritti. Rajju Vritti has taken place. Rajju Jnana, that is Rajju Vritti. Rajju Jnana Vritti Upahita Chaitanya Sakshi Chaitanya. Rajju Jnana Vritti Rupa Rajju Jnana Upahita Sakshi Chaitanya. So two Aumshas of Chaitanya have become one. Now these two Aumshas cannot be talked about as two at all because they have become one. They were one, now you know they are one. Thereby what has happened? Na tayor asti bhedaha. So this is so much detail. I don't think any doubt can remain after this. Anyway, if we don't remember different options also, whatever you understand, hold on to that. Atra ayam hetuhu. What happens? More details. Even if you have not understood this part also, more details. Nahi kvachidapi chaitanyasya asti bhedaha swarupataha. By their very nature, there itself is misconception. By their very nature, the different chaitanyas which are talked about are not really different. Swarupataha ekaha. So kvachidapi. Never, ever, in no area, if you say there is Chaitanya outside and inside, there is Jiva Chaitanya 1, Jiva Chaitanya 2, never is there a difference. This is Siddhanta, we all know this. Nahi kvachidapi chaitanyasya asti bhedaha swarupataha. But aswarupataha there is bheda, which is upadhi krita, kintu upadhi nibandana eva saha. Nibandana is karana, ludanta napumsaka linga. So upadhihi nibandanam equal to karanam yasya. Yasya bhedasya sa bhedaha upadhi nibandanaha. Meaning upadhi krita ityartha. In tatpurusha if you say upadhina krita, upadhi krita, bhedaha. Vrityupahita chaitanyasya rajyupahita chaitanyasya cha bheda prayojaka upadhihi vrittihi rajyuscha. Okay, what are the upadhis which have created bhedas? If you say vritti krita bhedau, there are two. Bhedas are, there are two now. So these divisions which are two, which are these two? There is one vritti upahita chaitanya. Vritti upahita chaitanya, what is the upadhi for vritti upahita chaitanya? Vritti. What is the upadhi for Rajju Upahita Chaitanya? Upadhi is Rajju. So, Vritti Upahita Chaitanyasya, Rajju Upahita Chaitanyasya cha Bheda Prayojaka Upadhi. The upadhi which has brought about Bheda, which has facilitated Bheda, difference. Otherwise, there is no difference in Chaitanya. What are these? There are two respectively, Vritti and Vrittihi and Rajju. Yada Vrittihi Rajju Rajyuscha. Now this Vritti, which is an Upadhi for Chaitanya causing Vritti Upahita Chaitanya, and Rajju, which is an Upadhi which is causing a Rajju Upahita Chaitanya outside. One is inside, the other is outside. This is the thinking for terminology to make a prakriya. Terminology is used to make a prakriya, and we have to hold by the details if you want to understand the prakriya. So yada vrittihi rajyuscha iti upadhi dvayam vibhinna deshastham tada tadupahita chaitanyayor bheda siddhyati. Now let's say there are upadhi krita bhedas. There is vritti upahita chaitanya and there is rajya upahita chaitanya. And what is in this? What is the context here? The context is the Purvapakshi is agreeing that the Rajju Upeta Chaitanya becomes known by Rajju Jnana. Therefore, Sarpa Nivritti takes place. Sarpa as a Vishaya. But Vritti Upeta Chaitanya, which is Sakshi Chaitanya, which is the Adhishthana for Sarpa Jnana, is not known. Therefore, Sarpa Jnana will not go away. In that context, we are looking at other option. First option we already answered, saying that Vishaya Bhavat, Sarpa Vishaya Bhavat, Sarpa Jnana Nivrittihi. Why? Because Vishayadhina, Jnayadhinam Jnanam. Once the Nimitta goes away, and we explain in another way also. Nimittasya, Nimitta goes away, Naimittika will also go away. Nimitta Bhave, Naimittikasya Abhi Abhavaha. But if you are insisting, you know, because there may be questions, we have explained, but still other way, the more ways you can explain it, the more the Siddhanta will settle down. So yada vrittihi, what is this? Now we have to establish that the vritti upaita chaitanya is also known. We have made a sangraha vakya that when the vritti goes out, it becomes the akara of the vishaya. So vishaya jnana takes place, then the vishaya adhishthana becomes known, which is the vishaya upahita chaitanya, but then the vritti gata chaitanya, vritti upahita chaitanya, which is sakshi chaitanya, has become one. Therefore, the vishaya avachinna chaitanya being known, general statement, vritti avahita chaitanya, upahita chaitanya is also known. So, vishaya upahita chaitanya is one with vritti upahita chaitanya. Therefore, vritti upahita chaitanya is also known. If it is known, then the adhishtana for the Brahma Vritti, which was earlier, that will also go away. Because Vritti Upaita Chaitanya, Sakshi Chaitanya is the Adhishthana for the Brahma Jnana, which is supposed to be within, but now the Adhishthana being known, that will also go away. So to establish that, now we are looking at general prakriya. In that context, we are looking at general prakriya. So any doubts in the general way, the way Siddhanti explains the Anirvachana Khyati, Anirvachaniya Khyati, and even theory of perception, how the perception takes place in Vedanta, those details are given. Yada vrittihi rajyuscha iti upadhi dvayam vibhinna deshastham. When the vritti and rajju are in separate deshas, when are they in the separate deshas, there is rajju outside and there is vritti inside, then you can say that there are two. But if they are in the same place, because vritti has traveled, antakkarana vritti goes out, and when it makes an vritti in the rajju desha, rajju vritti is not taking place inside, rajju vritti is taking place at the rajju sthala, that is a rajjvakara vritti. There you cannot raise an objection. You cannot even make a statement that they are two. Notionally also they are not two. Thereby what will happen? Yada vritti rajyuscha iti upadhi dvayam vibhinna deshastham. When the vritti and rajju are separate, then what will happen? Separated in space, then tada tadupahita chaitanya yor bheda. That is, this vritti as well as rajju, both of them, tadupahita chaitanya yor bheda siddhyati. There is a difference between the chaitanyas, which are having these two separate upadhis, and upadhis are at separate places. Therefore, chaitanya has to be talked about in separate places as though different. But there you can talk about the difference. Yadatu, on the other hand, if and when yadatu upadhyoho ekadeshastattvam bhavati tadana upahita chaitanyayor bhedaha. You cannot even talk about difference between the two when they are in the same place. wherever the Rajju Upahita Chaitanya is, there itself the Vritti Upahita Chaitanya is. Why? Because Rajju and Vritti are in the same place. So Upahita Chaitanyas are in the same place. How will you differentiate in one place? How can you have two Chaitanyas? There cannot be two Chaitanyas anywhere. That is a Siddhanta. But even if you say no, they are separated by Desha, we say they are Upadhi Krita Bhedas. He says, okay, Upadhi Krita Bhedas, at least accept that they are in different places. Okay, notionally we accept that. But now, if they are in the same Desha, how will you tell the difference between the two? How will you claim the difference between the two? There is no possibility for the Puro Pakshi to make an Aropa even. Make Bheda at all. Therefore, Tada Upahita Chaitanyor Bhedaha Na Siddhyati. Ayam Artha Vedanta Paribhashadi Granteshu Prasiddha. This is well known in the Vedanta Paribhasha and similar Granthas, Prakarana Granthas. Vibhinna Deshastha Upadibhyam Eva Upahita Chaitanyor Bheda Kalpyate. There's a Kalpana done of this Bheda notionally to explain the Prakriya only when the Upadis are in separate places. This is true with not only between Vishaya and Vritti, but in between Jiva and Jivas, Jiva and Ishvara, whatever you talk about. So, Maheshwara is in Kailasa, Narayana is in Vaikuntha. All these statements that we make, their Desha Bheda is there. Then there are other Upadis also. But we just talking about the Desha Bheda. Between Jiva 1 and Jiva 2, other Jivas are there. Similar is the setup. If the Deshas are different, then there is Bheda. But Ishvara is all pervasive. There is no Bheda. What is the difference between Ishvara Chaitanya and Jiva Chaitanya? No difference. Because Desha is not different at all. Even by one example, we can understand. Desha is not different. Because he is all pervasive. Isha Vasyam Idam Sarvam. How can he be separated out in Desha? He cannot be. Chaitanya is one. But anyway, coming back to the context. Vibhinna deshastha upadibhyam eva upahita chaitanyor bheda kalpyate dvayorapyupadhyor ekadeshastatvetu tabhyam upahitan chaitanyam api ekam eva iti siddhyati. When the two upadis, which are those vishaya and vritti, vishaya here rajju and vritti, rajju vritti, when they are at the same place. Dvayoropi upadyoho ekadeshastatvetu tabhyam upahitan chaitanyam api ekam eva iti siddhyati. Therefore, chaitanya which have upadhi of vritti and rajju being in the same place, chaitanya is also in the same place. You cannot differentiate them at all. They are one. Uktaritya Rajju Sakshatkara Dashayam Rajju Upahita Chaitanyam Vrityupahita Chaitanyam Cha Iti Etad Uvayam Eki Bhavati. And as explained earlier, when Rajju Sakshatkara takes place, Rajju Upahita Chaitanya, Rajju is at the same place where the Vritti takes place. Vritti goes out and it takes place via the Antakkarana Vritti. Antakkarana modifies in the form of Vritti while going out through the Chakshurindriya. Falling on the Rajju, there is Rajvakara Vritti. So Rajvakara Vritti is at the Rajju Desha. Therefore, Rajju Upahita Chaitanyam and Vritti Upahita Chaitanyam also are one. They become one. Eki Bhavati. In Buddhi, in thinking, they become one really. There was no difference. But even if you say they were segmented, okay, by Upadhi they were segmented, there was Vyavaharika Bheda. Now Vyavaharika Bheda is also not there. Chaitanya has become one because Rajju as an Upadhi and Vritti as an Upadhi are in the same place. Tatra Sakshi Chaitanyam Eva Vritti Upahita Chaitanyam Iti Uchyate. Now, when the Puro Pakshi says, okay, I understand, but I am asking about the Sakshi Chaitanya. What about Sakshi Chaitanya? Oh, Sakshi Chaitanya is Vritti Upahita Chaitanya. Vritti has come from within to outside. Who is within? Within there is Sakshi sitting. So Sakshi Chaitanyam, which is Sakshi who is Chaitanya Rupa, that Sakshi is backing the Vritti. Therefore, Tatra, in this setup that I have explained, the Siddhanti says, तत्र साक्षी चैतन्यमेव वृत्त्युपेत चैतन्यम् इति उच्यते। अन्तःकरणे तद्वृत्तौ च स्थित्वा अपि असंगतया तयोः अवभासक चैतन्य मात्रस्य साक्षित्वाभिधानात्। हु इज कॉल्ड एज अ साक्षी? साक्षी नाम इज गिवन टू हूम? टू चैतन्य। हु इज अवभासक? अवभासक चैतन्य मात्र। वी डू नॉट टेक एनीथिंग एल्स विथ साक्षी। साक्षी इज शुद्ध चैतन्य। देयरफॉर देयर इज नो रियल भेदा बिटवीन वन साक्षी एंड द अदर साक्षी। देयर इज नो रियल भेदा। सो अवभासक चैतन्य हु लाइट्स अप एवरीथिंग इन हिज प्रेजेंस, दैट चैतन्य मात्र, शुद्ध चैतन्य इज कॉल्ड अ साक्षी। वेयर इज ही नाउ? अंतकरणे तद्वृत्तौ च। अंतकरण एंड अंतकरण वृत्ति, इन अंतकरण एज वेल एज अंतकरण वृत्ति। अंतकरण इटसेल्फ मॉडिफाइज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वृत्ति। देयरफॉर अंतकरणे अंतकरण वृत्तौ च स्थित्वा, स्टेइंग देयर दिस साक्षी अपि असंगतया, जस्ट लाइक सूर्यः लाइट्स अप द एंटायर प्रपंच बट हिमसेल्फ इज नॉट टेंटेड, नॉट एसोसिएटेड विथ एनीथिंग इन द वर्ल्ड। सिमिलरली साक्षी चैतन्य इज इन द same antakarana which modifies in the form of vritti but still unconnected by whatever vritti. Ravana thought of Sita aparana, in that vritti also sakshi chaitanya was there. Rama who was crying and who defeated Ravana also had the same sakshi chaitanya as swarupa which was backing the धर्म कार्य। सो अधर्म कार्य एंड अधर्म कार्य वृत्ति विच इज टेकिंग प्लेस इन द माइंड एज वेल एज धर्म कार्य, धर्म वृत्ति इज टेकिंग प्लेस इन द माइंड, बोथ हैव साक्षी चैतन्य एज अवभासक बोथ, बट देन इज द साक्षी टेंटेड? रावण, रावण स्वरूप इज ऑल्सो रियली स्वरूपतः ब्रह्मात्मा चैतन्य, साक्षी चैतन्य, शुद्ध चैतन्य। इट इज नॉट affected at all by anything that the upadhis do. Anyway, this is an aside to show how the antakarane tadvruttau cha stitvapi asangataya tayoh avabhasaka chaitanya matrasya sakshitva abhidhanat. Asangataya, the example of Ravana is given for asangataya. This is prathama malla nyaya. Ravana is one of the worst in the dharma shastra, worst we can say. So even that kind of a person, even in that case, tatra there is asanga atma which is swarupataha there, which facilitates adharma karya also just by mere presence. This, the way this sun facilitates theft also, murders also, all the worst of the karyas, adharma karyas also take place in broad daylight when the sun lights it up, at night when the moon reflects the sun's lights and lights it up. But there is no kartrutva there. There is no association because Surya is asanga to any karya that takes place. Similarly, the vritti is taking place in the mind, antakarana, whatever, however bad the antakarana is, however ashuddha it is, whatever are the vasanas, whatever are the ragadveshas, and the vrittis keep on taking place, still being there itself is sakshi chaitanya asanga. Who is asanga? He is the sakshi. Tayoho avabhasaka chaitanya matrasya sakshitvabhidhana. This sakshi, if he is not tainted by the worst of the adharma karyas, what is the connection of this sakshi with the upadhis? No connection at all. Rajju upadhi, sarpa upadhi, vritti or vishaya, there is no connection whatsoever. There is no segmentation at all, but still we have used the segmentation to explain the prakriya. There is bheda, deshagata bheda. Desha is one now, thereby the vritti उपहित चैतन्य एज वेल एज दि विषय उपहित चैतन्य हैव बिकम वन एंड वृत्ति चैतन्य वृत्तिगत चैतन्य इज साक्षी चैतन्य अलोन देयरफॉर उक्त रीत्या रज्जु साक्षात्कार समये साक्षी चैतन्यस्य रज्जु उपहित चैतन्यस्य च भेद सिद्धः देन रज्जु उपहित चैतन्य बीइंग नोन साक्षी चैतन्य इज ऑल्सो नोन बिकॉज वृत्ति उपहित चैतन्य इज नोन Once it is known, Vrittyupahita Chaitanya is known, Sakshi Chaitanya is the name for Vrittyupahita Chaitanya. Who is Asanga? रज्जु उपैत चैतन्यं च रज्जु ज्ञानीन उपासते. रज्जु ज्ञान हैज मेड दी रज्जु उपैत चैतन्य टू रिवील इटसेल्फ अवभासते. देयर बाय रज्जु उपैत चैतन्यात अपृथक भूतम विच इज नॉन डिफरेंट फ्रॉम रज्जु उपैत चैतन्य विच इज नोन बाय रज्जु ज्ञान. वॉट इज अपृथक? साक्षि चैतन्यम. सो साक्षि चैतन्यम अपि रज्जु ज्ञानीन एव अवभासते. We don't need any other explanation also. As soon as you Rajju Jnana takes away Rajju Ajnana, Rajju Vipayata Chaitanyam Swayameva Prakashate. Rajju Vipayata Chaitanyam is in the same place where Rajju is, where the Vritti has taken place. Therefore, Vritti also, Rajju Vritti which has taken place there, that is also the Adhishthana called as Sakshi. Sakshi Chaitanya. Therefore, Rajju Vipayata Chaitanya being known, Sakshi Chaitanya is known. Due to what? Rajju Jnana. Rajju Jnanena, Rajju Vipayata Chaitanyam Swayameva Prakashate. Tasmad Apratagbhutam Sakshi Chaitanyam Api Rajju Jnaneneva Avabhasate. Both are known simultaneously. Both avidyas are countered simultaneously. And both Vishaya and Jnana, Brahmasthala, in the Brahmasthala, both Adhyastha, the Vishaya Padartha as well as the Vishaya Jnana or Padartha Jnana go away simultaneously by one unit of knowledge, which is the Adhishthana Jnana, non-different from the Padartha Rajju, Rajju Jnana, Rajju Jnanena, non-different from the Rajju Jnana, not Padartha, Padartha Jnana. Evam Rajju Sakshatkara Samaye Sarpa Jnana Adhishthana Bhuta Sakshi Chaitanyasya Bhana Sattvat तत्र कल्पित सर्प ज्ञानस्यापि निवृत्ति संभवति. देयरफॉर सर्प निवृत्ति टेकिंग प्लेस ड्यू टू रज्जु ज्ञान एट द सेम टाइम कल्पित सर्प ज्ञान आल्सो गोज अवे. हाउ? रज्जु साक्षात्कार समये एज एक्सप्लेन एट दैट टाइम व्हाट हैपेंस? सर्प ज्ञान अधिष्ठान भूत. सर्प ज्ञान अधिष्ठान साक्षी चैतन्य. साक्षी चैतन्य इज इन दी वृत्ति विच इज फॉर्मिंग रज्ज्वाकार वृत्ति एट दी रज्जु देश. सो रज्जु ज्ञानेन रज्जु देशे रज्जु ज्ञानेन रज्जु साक्षात्कार समये रज्जु उपहित चैतन्यम स्वयमेव प्रकाशते, विच इज नॉन डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दि साक्षी चैतन्य विच इज दि अधिष्ठान फॉर दि सर्पज्ञान. देयरफॉर सर्पज्ञान विल आल्सो गो अवे. व्हाई? अधिष्ठान बीइंग नोन दिस अध्यस्त आरोपित विल गो अवे विच हैपेंस टू बी सर्पज्ञान. सो एवं रज्जु साक्षात्कार समय सर्पज्ञान अधिष्ठान भूत साक्षी चैतन्यस्य भानसत्वात् तत्र कल्पित सर्पज्ञानस्य आरोपित अध्यस्थ सर्पज्ञानस्यापि निवृत्ति संभवति. इट इज पॉसिबल देयर बाय इट हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन अनदर वे आल्सो. सकल त्रिपुटी भान समये साक्षी भानम अवश्यं भवति इति निरूपणम्. देन देयर इज अनदर वे टू एक्सप्लेन, अथवा थर्ड वे टू एक्सप्लेन इज त्रिपुटी इज बिकमिंग वन. We have explained by showing the Vishaya Gata Chaitanya and Vritti Gata Chaitanya as being one. And we have said Vritti Gata Chaitanya is Sakshi Chaitanya. Now we show the Triputi. Then there is a triad, not two. There is a triad, and how triad in the case of Triputi, how does it work? Because Vritti and the Jiva, who is a Pramata, we make the Bheda also. Pramata. There is a Prameya and there is Pramana. This is the Triputi. So, Jnanam, Jneya, Jnanam, Jneyam and Jnata, Jnatru. This is the Triputi. There are three. How do you explain taking two? How do you make Sakshi Chaitanya one with the Vritti? Sakshi Chaitanya, who is supposed to be Antakkarana Nishta. Back in the Antakkarana. Antakkarana is the Upadhi of the Jiva. How can you make Sakshi Chaitanya, who appears as Jiva in the Antakkarana, reflected in the Jiva, in the Antakkarana, how do you make him one with the Vritti? So there may be such questions also. So we are giving another option. Sakala Triputi Bhana Samaye Sakshi Bhanam Avashyam Bhavati Iti Nirupanam. You are interested in Sakshi Bhana, Sakshi Chaitanya Jnana. We'll tell you that will take place when Triputi, we take Triputi also. Sakala Triputi Bhana Samaye, when the entire Triputi is known, that time Sakshi also is known. How so? Athava Kutastha Deepe Vidyaranya Munibhihi Itthamuktam. So Bhagavan Vidyaranyacharya explains in in one kutastha deepa prakarana in panchadashi the lamp the kutastha deepa is the lamp where it reveals everything it shows light upon everything without any kartrutva bhava just by the mere presence swabhavata there what does bhagwan vidyarana say antakaranasya vrittihi chidabhasa sahita चक्षुरादि करण द्वारा बहिर्निर्गत्य घटादि विषयान प्रकाशयति दिस मच वी नो घटा एग्जांपल इज टेकन घटादि घटपटा इत्यादि रज्जु अंतकरणस्य वृत्ति अंतकरण मॉडिफाइज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वृत्ति एंड चिदाभास सहित देयर इज चिदाभास देयर बिकॉज देयर इज आभास ऑफ चैतन्य इन द अंतकरण देन वृत्ति कैन नॉट एक्ट ऑन इट्स ओन देयर इज चिदाभास सो इज चिदाभास सहित अंतकरण वृत्ति goes out chakshuradi karana dwara through the golaka through the use due to the indriyas going out through the golaka the vritti also goes out but chidabhasa is definitely there then what has happened having gone outside bahir nirgatya ghatadi vishayan prakashayati okay it lights up the it reveals the ghata ityadi ghata jnana takes place pata jnana takes place etc vishaya jnana takes place generic term What happens there? Tatra ghatadi rupa vishaya. Ghata is the vishaya. In the Triputi, ghata is the vishaya, which is called as a jneya vastu. Prameya, chidabhasa sahita vritti rupam ghatadi vishayakam jnanam. Jnanam. What is a jnanam? Jnanam is chidabhasa sahita vritti rupam, which is chidabhasa sahita vritti that takes the Vishaya as ghata. Ghatadi vishayaka jnanam. That is called as jnanam. So ghatadi vishayakam chidabhasa sahita vritti rupam is jnanam. We got the second in the Triputi. What is the third in the triad? Chidabhasa sahita antakkarana rupa jnata. Antakkarana becomes the upadi. In fact, antakkarana can be said to be vishishta also. Visheshana also. So antakkarana vishishta chaitanya also. और चिदाभास चिदाभास सहित अंतकरण रूप ज्ञाता चिदाभास इज अ टर्म यूज फॉर इन आभासवाद अदरवाइज प्रतिबिंब चैतन्य इन प्रतिबिंबवाद भगवान विद्यारण्याचार्य यूजेस बोथ ही यूजेस चिदाभास देर आभासवाद ही यूजेस इन दिस कूटस्थ दीप सो चिदाभास सहित अंतकरण रूप ज्ञाता द नोअर नॉलेज एंड द To be known Vishaya or the known Vishaya. The object, the subject, and the knowledge. This is the triad. Means to know the object. So there is a subject, there is an object division, subject-object division, and then the means to know the object for the subject. Subject has a means to know. That becomes the jnanam, ludanta, karane vikpatti. Not karane vitpatti, karane in the sense means, of course, but then here it bhave, knowledge. So, bhave vitpatti there. Karana would be, mean, it can pramana. So, you can say karane vitpatti also, but here we translate as knowledge, not means to knowledge. The knowledge itself is the means to knowing the vishaya, object. So, anyway, however you understand it, vishaya, jnana, jnata, pramana, prameya, pramana, and pramatru. Or Nyeyam, Jnanam and Jnata. So Vishaya is Nyeya Vastu. This is the Etatrayam api Sakshi Prakashati. Sakshi is the one who lights up the object, the subject as well as the knowledge, Jnanam. So Nyeya, Jnana and Jnata, all three are revealed by the Sakshi. This is what Panchadashikara says. Asyayam Artha, what is the meaning of that though? Ayam Ghataha. This is a pot. In that case, what is happening? Ayanghata iti jnane sati. When that jnana takes place, this is a pot. What is happening? Sabhasa antakkarana vrittya ghata matram prakashate. Only ghata is known. When only ghata is known, that time what happens? Only ghata shines forth. And then I say this is a pot. It is known from the way I construct the statement. If I say this is a pot, then Only ghata is known. So, ghata matram prakashati. Sabhasa antakkarana vrittya. Through the vritti of the antakkarana or antakkarana appearing in the form of vritti, घटाकार वृत्ति साभास अंतकरण आभास चिदाभास सहित दैट काइंड ऑफ अंतकरण वृत्ति विच इज बैक्ड बाय चिदाभास विच इज अ रिफ्लेक्शन और आभास अ सेम्ब्लेंस ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस देयर बाय देयर इज अ काइंड ऑफ अ सेंशियंस देयर घट मात्र प्रकाशते ओनली घट इज नोन देन व्हेन आई से आई नो द पॉट और आई सी द पॉट घटम अहम जानामि इत्यत्र तु इन दैट स्टेटमेंट अहम इति शब्दस्य अर्थ यह ज्ञाता हाउ विल द ट्रायड बी नोन ओनली व्हेन यू से घटम अहम जानामि अहम घट देयर इज अ विषय ओनली विषय घट अयम घट दिस इज अ पॉट But that shows this is a pot is a unit of knowledge. This is a pot is a unit of knowledge. So jnana is there. Ayam ghataha vishaya or the jnaya is there. Object is there. But somehow the subject is not there in the sentence. Although the subject is there without the subject, ayam ghataha cannot be known as well. When I say this is a pot, who knows this is a pot? I know that this is a pot. So I is there, pervading both the knowledge as well as the underlying I which precedes all this. That is always there. I am there before I say this is a pot. So and if you look at the entire construct, I thought comes up before I make a statement that this is a pot. I know that this is a pot. That is a complete construct. But somehow in this construct, I is missing. The jnata is missing. So for Triputi to be explained, he takes a better example, which is ghatamaham janami. Once you say this is a pot, and then I say, oh, I see a pot, I know the pot, then ghatamaham janami. There what has happened? Ityatratu aham, which is sitting there. Ayam ghata there, aham isn't there, seen. Although it is there, it is not seen in the sentence. Therefore, ghatamaham janami, there Triputi is clear, ityatratu. अहम इति शब्दस्य अर्थ यह ज्ञाता ज्ञातृ द नोअर द सीयर घट इति यह ज्ञेयः द ज्ञेय वस्तु विषय विच इज घट प्रमेय जानामि इति यद् घट विषयकं ज्ञानम द नॉलेज यूनिट एज आई द जानामि नो आई नो सो देयर इन आई नो ऑल्दो हियर ऑल्सो आई इज सिटिंग देयर I is superfluous. Aham is superfluous in Janami because Mip Pratyaya is unique. Janami has to be Aham Janami. It cannot be the Madhyama or the Prathama Purusha. It is Uttama Purusha and is Ekavachana. So Aham Janami is sitting here. But Janami part of Aham Janami in that the Tinganta Pada there is Jnanam. There is a Kriya taking place which is this Jnana Rupa. So Ghata Vishayakam Jnanam. It is very unique to Ghata. Ghata Vishaya. Ghata is Vishaya for Vijnana, that is Ghata Vishayakam Jnana. Bhauri, ityetat trayam api triputi rupam sakshi prakashayati iti. Only sakshi reveals the ghataha, aham as well as janami. All three are known to the sakshi. Jnata, jnayam, jnanam cha ityetat trayam api triputi ityuchyate. All these three are called as a triad, triputi. Ittham eva sarvatra nikhila triputi prakashaka sakshi eva. Wherever there is a Triputi, all the individuals in the Triputi, individual units or parts in the Aumshas in the Triputi are revealed by Sakshi. Prakashaka is always Sakshi Chaitanya. Yadi Sakshi Swayam Ajnata Syat, Tada Triputi Jnanam Na Sakshina Jayeta. How can you make a claim as the triad is known, but the Sakshi is not known? Without the Sakshi being known, you cannot have without aham being there. I cannot say I know myself, but I see the pot. I may know myself any which way, erroneously. But if you discount the error, I know myself rightfully with the additional noise of the body, mind, sense complex. So I, Sakshi, is always known because I know that I am conscious. I exist. I may not know that I am Ananda Swarupa, but Sat and Chit is known. Sat is definitely known. Chit also may not be known clearly, but Sat is always known. I exist. Therefore, Samanya Jnana of Aham is already always there. Yadi Sakshi Swayam Ajnata Syat Tada Tripudi Jnanam Na Sakshina Jayeta. साक्षी कैनॉट रिवील दी अदर थ्री इफ ही हिमसेल्फ इज अननोन तस्मात् सकल त्रिपुटि ज्ञान दशायां साक्षी ज्ञानम अवश्यम जायत एव स्वयं प्रकाशत्वा साक्षिणः साक्षी स्वयं प्रकाश देर इज नथिंग विच विल रिवील दी साक्षी साक्षी रिवील्स एवरीथिंग एल्स देयरफॉर साक्षी इज ऑलवेज नोन रियली देन देर इज एडिशनल नॉइज देयरफॉर साक्षी इज मिस्ड साक्षी बीइंग मिस्ड डज नॉट मीन अननोन इति अभ्युपेयम इट शुड डेफिनेटली बी एक्सेप्टेड दैट साक्षी इज नोन वेन तस्मा सकल त्रिपुटी ज्ञान दशायाम इफ यू थिंक ओवर वेन एवर आई अंडरस्टैंड द त्रिपुटी डू आई अंडरस्टैंड देर इज आई एम द सब्जेक्ट देर इज एन ऑब्जेक्ट एंड आई नो द ऑब्जेक्ट इन दैट केस आई एम नोन I cannot say I know the subject, object, as well as the knowledge taking place, but I do not know myself. I cannot make a statement. The inner revealer is, the revealer is known, is already revealed. The inner revealer is revealed first and then the other parts of the Triputi. Iti abhyupayam, it should definitely be accepted. Anena cha sakshi jnanena sarpa jnanam nivartate. So, Sakshi Jnana, who is he? So, coming back to the objection after explaining the Prakriya as per Panchadashikara, then we say, Anena cha Sakshi Jnanena Sarpa Jnana Nivartate. Why? Sakshi Jnana is Sarpa Jnana Adhishthana. Therefore, Sakshi Jnana has taken place. Adhishthana has taken place. Sarpa Jnana, which is Abhyasa, Aropita, goes away. Uktaritya Sarpadi Mithya Vishesya Chajnanasya cha Prithakyeva Adhishthanam Ichyabhyupagama पक्षे इयंत्याक्षेप समाधानानि समभवन् सो दीज आर ऑल पॉसिबल इयंत्याक्षेप समाधानानि दीज काइंड ऑफ आक्षेपास एंड दीज थ्री वेज ऑफ समाधानास आर ऑल वेरी वेल पॉसिबल दे हैव बीन एक्सप्लेन उक्तरीत्या सर्पादि मिथ्या विषयस्य सो इन द एग्जांपल ऑफ प्रातिभासिक सत्ता वी हैव एक्सप्लेन उक्तरीत्या इन भ्रमस्थला तज्ञानस्य च मिथ्या विषय एंड ज्ञान तज्ञान पृथगेव अधिष्ठानम् इति अभ्युपगम पक्षे व्हेन वी टेक दैट दी अधिष्ठानस आर डिफरेंट फॉर बोथ इवन देन दीज थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ ऑल दी सॉर्ट्स ऑफ ऑब्जेक्शन इनफैक्ट वन ऑब्जेक्शन मेन ऑब्जेक्शन वॉज एंसर्ड इन मेनी वेज ऑल दिस कैन बी डन as explained. So that is the 147th avartana. Then mithya sarpasya tajnanasya cha adhishthanam sakshi eva iti nirupanam. Now the mithya sarpa and tajnana, what is the adhishthana for this? Not different, they are one. This paksha is being explained. This is coming more close to the siddhanta, closer and closer to the siddhanta. You take away all the gaurava. Why should there be two adhishthanas at all? We can explain by using one adhishthana. Then you will not have the adhishthana bheda question, one going away, one being known, the other not being known. What is your explanation? The Purvapakshi cannot ask. But we can we establish that the Rajju and Rajju Jnana or Sarpa and Sarpa Jnana has a single adhishthana? Sarpa and Sarpa Jnana, do they have the same adhishthana? That is also possible. We'll see in the next part. Sorry, already late for the patha. Sukhanityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Nama Rupayo Adhishtanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhir Drukyatya Nirvanam Aparam Sarva Vedanta Vedyam Pratyak Param Maha Tadeva Annamattvanyam Iti Menishchita Matihi. Namaste. I'll see you in the next patha and we look at the Adhishtana being same for Mithya Sarpa and Sarpa Jnana.
Namaste.
Hariyo.